mostly outspoken artist. I want to do something a little different today. I want to do a little commentary. I want to share with you some of the comments that I had on my latest sketch, which I didn't expect to have that many responses, but in hindsight, it was a touchy issue, so possibly, you know, I was kind of wrong. It's the one where it says, "It's too late to cry." And I went out on a limb, and I want to thank everybody for understanding creatively why I drew it the way I drew. Actually, it started out as a little doodle that I carried with me on a very small pad. Now, I don't want to have to run away from the screen and show you how small it is, but I will eventually. Maybe I'll, before the whole thing is over. But it's on a small piece of paper, about rectangular, about this size. And you all know that I love to write, I love to draw, I love to communicate and express myself. So I carried this thing with me, and I just started. And the message came to me the same way it usually does. Not always in the beginning. I'll have an idea where I want to go with it, but the closer I get to finishing the picture, the more it zeroes in on what I want to have as the completed message. And it came to me. And, you know, as you can see, it's a nude woman in the bathroom. She has a hand up, and she has the envelope in her hand. And you can see the words I put on there. Now, we know that when somebody gets notified of their HIV status after taking a test, if it is not right then and there, they will call you, and they will have you come in. It's never where they're going to send you a letter, because if it gets into the wrong hands, your private business is it's public. But for the sake of creativity and proving a point, I put the whole illustration that way. And the words that I basically put, don't have it in front of me to memorize it, but I basically said, why is it that our daughters will get a baby before a high school diploma and HIV status, or being HIV positive, before they even have a chance to begin to live life? And that's a dilemma. It's a dilemma enough to have a child at a very young age when you could have made a different choice. And this is a very touchy subject that I went into, and I don't want to step on any toes, but you're not going to see this kind of stuff anywhere else. So, you know, I don't want any misunderstandings. When I say a bad choice, most of the time when you are 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, even 18 years old, and even younger than that, it's not usually something that you chose. You make the best of it. On the other hand, certain things are allowed to happen, I feel. If it happened, it was supposed to happen. Sometimes with our bad choices that come from behavior where we weren't thinking as youngsters can be turned around for the good. But the suffering and sacrifice comes when you're not equipped to deal with a situation like that. So that being said, God can turn a situation around. And that child that you have that was tough to raise, and it might have cut your childhood earlier, just remember that that could be the answer to cancer. That child can grow up and be a doctor and cure AIDS. So things happen, and in hindsight, it's always 20/20, like they say. And that's really, really the truth. But I want to give a shout out, and I don't have their names written down, but you can go to that particular photo in my photo section and click and look at the comments. And there are a few young ladies who really took the time to write and share their experiences about what they had to go through when they were pregnant at an early age, and continue to go through, even though they're much older now. And I like that. And I think that took a lot of courage. And do know that with my illustrations, I am not making fun of anybody. I'm not coming down on anybody. But nobody really wants to go and get touchy on these things or be the first one to stand up and say something about it. So I think it's a very healthy thing for a lot of people that with my illustrations that I'm blessed to do with the gift that God gave me. So I have a responsibility to put stuff out there. Like I said, I have no time to draw pretty bowls of fruit. or nature scenes, when there are people suffering and people that need guidance or need to jumpstart their thinking or need to know through an illustration or some type of creative expression that somebody understands what you're going through. Sometimes an illustration like that can prevent a person from getting into a situation they're not ready for, or it can be soothing to let somebody know, hey, you know, this person understands what I'm in, you know, and anybody who's in a situation would also want to share what they've been through to help somebody else not get in that situation. So that's the only way I'm coming. But I'm going to be doing some things for the new year coming in 2010. It's going to be very gritty, and I'm going to talk about it. And sometimes you may not understand where I'm coming from. All I'm saying is just give me the benefit of the doubt. Just don't jump on me too fast, because I really want to look at things on a deeper level. And I'm going to throw some things out there that you're not going to see anywhere else. Because, see, I don't have to worry about ratings. I don't have to worry about sponsors. I don't have to worry about my image or if I'm going to lose sponsorship with any company. I'm independent. It's just a camera, the pad, the pencil, my computer, my scanner, my office, which I'm in right now, and what I think. So I'm not limited. And what I want you all to do, share. Go into the comment page. Don't just go there and look. You know, I want to get some interaction. Give me some suggestions. Give me some comments. I'll share them on the videos. I'll give you some shout-outs. I'll blow you up on the video. Trust me. You know what I mean? But just keep everything coming. And I love the emails, but please, let's all interact. It's not about me. I want everybody to see everybody else's ideas and their thoughts and how they feel about certain things. So I'll do the drawing. I got the page up. I'll take the time, the hours, my days off, nights, when I come in the wee hours and do what I do. When I throw it out there to you all, I want you all to react to it. I want you all to talk about it. And that will give me, while I stand by the sidelines, more impetus and more insight to say, hey, you know, that's a good point. Let me touch on that. And I think I've been talking long enough. The rest of the video, or what you saw earlier, depending on how I edit it, you know, I hope you enjoy it. And like I said, let's start off something new and have some fun with this thing. And also, happy Thanksgiving. Even though you know how I feel about Thanksgiving, and you know the real deal about Thanksgiving, let's just not forget it, I'm saying, but let's redefine it. We know what the pilgrims did and the forefathers of this country did with Thanksgiving. Let's turn it into something else where we give thanks for what we have now, but we never forget the people who suffered and lost their land and lost their culture. You know, nobody wants to say that, and I want to do something on that too. But anyway, leave me your comments on the photo page, all over the page. Let's all react and get to know each other, you know, because we can take a pastime as simple as going in front of the computer and the internet, and we don't understand. There may be somebody out there that needs to hear what you have to say if you comment on something that I did. You know what I mean? So we throw things out there. We don't know who's listening, who may come out of nowhere and say, hey, you know, that really helped me. You really need to know the emails that I get. Try to put it on the page, all right? Take care. Bye-bye.